Hey guys, Rewind here. Back on the Dawn of Sorrow once again. So we're heading back today. Pinning, that's it. No, wait, I'm going exactly the wrong way. Never mind. There we go. And then this color. Because we need to get to a warp room. That's the last time we... Oh yeah, battle paranoia, and I never went home there at all. Now that we've got paranoia, we can... fight Dario properly. Because we could get the bad ending just by, well, one of the bad endings, by just fighting him as he appears normally. But because he has a mirror in his room, which is the only mirror we haven't gone through to get loot, because there is no loot and it's in the boss room. We can, go fight a big ass fire demon called the Goomy. At this point that the enemies start being quite a bit harder than previous. Especially when they glitch out, not much just then. I am honestly kind of scared what a Goonie will be like. Given Randall. It's Danslip I already had, which evolves from Durandal. Can't go through that way. This is the first run through I've ever seen it happen. And there's an Alaska here. Big floppy sword dude. Actually drops some quite useful stuff. It's the final guard that dropped the useful sword. Alistair drops a useful sword in Portrait of Ruin. Okay, yeah, not going that way. facing a super glitch final guard. They're hard enough to fight regularly. And they're almost as bad as the iron golems for damage resistance. Only taking them. Let's see the. They're very minimal when they go. Okay. And the amount of damage they take. Yeah. Okay. Flaming, yeah. Three dead warriors. Save room, yep. I think that's the closest one to the boss room. Kind of annoying for the distance that it's still to go. But, and there's another final guard in here. Yeah. As far as I know, however, there's no decent living in any of those, so it's no real loss. Ooh, a frag wrench. And Satan's ring. Ooh. 3 points of defense for 11 points of strength, I think. And boss battle. Dario and his mirror image, the Goonie. What took you so long? I'll show you why you can't become the Dark Lord, because you suck! Blah 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 blah. Yes, Julius sucks at fighting. So, power's nothing if you don't know how to use it. Never lose to a fool like you. What was the point of power if you don't use it? So that's all I'm really first. Sure, bloody, bloody, blah. Step through the mirror. Huh. Surprisingly intact, given his size, although I suppose he doesn't really have many moving parts. Either that, or the bosses are still in a different area to the bit that's broken with all the final guards and great axe armors and iron golems and everything. All that dangerous. Just, yeah. Thank you. Yeah, when he swoops like that, he does get low enough to actually hit that. And his fireballs do hurt a lot more than I thought they did. Go. And always takes too long. Most of the actual bosses from here that didn't actually get reused fully in Portrait of Ruin showed up as bonus bosses in a secret area. All with most of them with fancy item drops. Get the health. Oh yeah. And the gooey soul. Back to the mirror. And there he goes. The hell? Yes. I ripped out your power. Suck it. And then he runs off. And then Celia shows up because presumably she was just lurking outside the door waiting for something to happen. I'm much more than she had imagined. Of course I am. Bloody bloody blah, stupid chase. Of course she's not concerned about this, she has a plan. And her plan? Oh yeah, more than one way to make a Dark Lord. Bloody bloody blah, candidates. The game isn't over just yet. The centre of the castle. Sure. So we're going to end this, we will. First, I need to show you something. Of course she needs to show me something. To get into that room, I need this magic suit. My favourite, I think, of all the magic suits. And some of the early ones are pretty simple, whereas this one's more complex, and therefore it'll be a bit harder to do with this. But, just in terms of aesthetics, not to mention it's the one that's actually shown on the title screen. Why isn't there, why can't there be a save room or a walk room more near barrier of boss fight? Well, I'll pause this here and resume when I've reached the centre of the castle. Yeah, I just took a side trip to the condemned tower to open another of the money doors. Oh, okay, I didn't realise that that would get there. I opened it and got a nice ring. Okay. Anyway, now to the middle of the castle. Okay, here we are at the middle of the castle. There's actually two endings at this point, and I'm going to get the worst one first because it's the one I kind of like. And I'll come back and actually get the one that's continue the story. Okay, so there's Mina. Someone's girlfriend type person hanging from a thing, and Celia goes, boom, I'm gonna kill her. with a magic laser beam. Oh, she's dead. Someone goes grumpy. And summons the power of darkness. You'll pay for this. The power of chaos, sorry, not the power of darkness. When your hatred peaks and you don't launch, you'll emerge, blah blah blah. Revenge! Make me the Dark Lord. Okay. The birth of the new Dark Lord, and... aha! Boom! You annoy me. That's why I punch you. Yep. Bloody bloody blah. And meanwhile, outside the castle. Yep. So is the Dark Lord now. Julius goes, right, time to kill him. Bloody bloody blah. Alucard gives you a heavy hint for getting the good version of this scene. Equip me this talisman, the most useless item that exists, would have protected him. I will have to unleash my power as Dracula's son. Well done. Julius mode unlocked. Data saved. Roll credits. And... yep. The good version of that scene plays out almost the same. At least to start with. But where is Mina's tower? The only item that provides precisely no boost to any skill. I realised this slug poisoned me, but I never actually tried starting the cutscene while status affected. Mina, okay, effect goes off. All the last moments of her life. Blah 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 blah. Flash flash flash. Laser. Death. Summer flips out, and the talisman doesn't actually appear to have any effect on him flipping out and the power of Chaos Gathering. Hatred peaking, New Dark Lord, revenge, and New Dark Lord, scream, and then Alucard shows up. Don't be a fool. That's obviously not Mina. Why do you always get in the way? I could have used a doppelganger. And... oh look, I'm on fire. Feel ill, vomit forth the power of dark chaos, not darkness, onto the doppelganger, and... flash, flash, flash. Look who it is! Dimitri! Yes. Yes, he did die. But he's back now, because he can cheat. Yes. He stole my power. Blah, blah, blah. Dracula needs to... the new Dark Lord needs to... doesn't need the power, just needs the same ability. Sure. Only he could gain that ability, except for me, because I already have it. I think. Bloody bloody blah, won't allow that. How did you get access to memories of my character's past lives? Bloody bloody blah. He was just low on power signifies. Dominance over more powerful demons. Let's get out of here. take back what I said. It seems death is your only destiny. They've gone to the basement of the condemned tower. Must be a portal to the dark side there. Or do anything rash. Sure. No one's going to want to stop it. Well, in that case, let's just... Yeah. The poisonous slug dropped the snail, dropped anti-venom. Useful. Anyway, let's just quickly get that one last bit of plot development over, and then end the episode. So, let's jump down the entire condemned tower. Woohoo! Okay, and... into here. Julius and Alucard are going... can we break this barrier? Yes, we can break this barrier. Bloody, bloody, blah. Can't get through. It has to be you breaking it. This is an emergency. Stand back. And Julius goes... Glowy things explode. Okay. Bloody blob, etc. Okay. Anyway, I'll see you all next time. Bye bye.